Hi friends, welcome to English Easy Learn. To lead our life, either we should be employed as a government employee or as a private employer, or we should be self-employed. That is, we should be having our own job or business or labor work. It might be anything for that matter. So, if you see our government, it is a legal body which has to provide basic amenities or basic facilities for the public, that is citizen of that particular country. And if you see, our government, is it providing all the basic facilities for that particular people or for the people of that particular country? Do you agree with that? No, I don't agree with that, because 8th December there was a headlines saying that TN government lacks with toilet facility, and a government employee called Saranya, who was 24 years old, died in a septic tank. Do you think that the government is not able to provide a basic amenity for the government employee who is working for the government? But do you think the government will provide you all the basic necessity facilities or the amenities for the public like us, who is going to elect the leader by just having a fingerprint for once in 5 years? Do you agree with that? See, my dear friends, what happens is the government, it has to take certain measures for the welfare and the development of the people as well as the country. My own experience is, once I visited a government hospital along with my family member, and actually that family member was suffering from a labor pain, and she was admitted in the maternity ward. But the worst experience that I had with the government hospital is the toilets, the basic facility, that is the toilet, is not at all fit for usage. You know, there is no proper door, there is no proper lock, and there is no good water facilities. And on the one side, if you see, the complete toilet is dumped with the stone, rocks and other wastage materials. And if you see on the floor, the water is stagnant. Mosquitoes are there. So friends, what is hospital? Hospital is a service place where you are rendering a health service for the public and for the people. Why do people come to the hospital? To cure their disease. Not to take away some more disease along with them to their place. Correct. Hospital is a place where the doctors and the nurses and the other staffs are curing the disease of the people and sending them to home as a normal man or a woman. But if people are scared to go to hospital by looking at the basic facilities, what in case if I get any other disease like that, then what is the use of going to government hospital? My dear friends, see, the people who opt for government hospital, maybe they are from a below poverty line. Or nowadays, if you see, majority of them are opting for a government hospital. Because due to the pandemic condition that is there in our country, people are not ready to go for a private hospital. But what should the government do? The government has to provide basic necessities and basic amenities for all the citizens of that particular country. Taking vote is not at all important, but after taking oath, whether you win in that political party or whether you lose in that political party, your ultimate goal is to serve for the people and for the country. That is really very important. And a small suggestion for all the doctors, whether it might be a private hospital or it might be a government hospital. See, my dear friends, the people, the patients who come to the hospital, definitely they will be coming with one or the other kind of pain in them. In their physical body, they'll be having some or the other pain. To cure that only, they are coming to you people. But show them the loyalty, the care, by telling few words, because they think that doctor is everything for them once they enter into the hospital. So please tell them, do not worry, we are there to help you. We are there to cure you. Try your level best to cure them. Then the remaining is in the hands of the Lord. It is not in your hands, but do your level the best. You do the maximum treatment that you can try to do it for the people. But if the people who come to the government hospitals are illiterates, are uneducated, you should be able to convince them in the way they can understand, but not just shouting at them. Please do not show your ego and attitude at the patients. They are the patients who are suffering and who are coming to you for help. So please treat them properly. Give them the proper instructions. Tell them what is the problem in their body. Tell them how it can be cured. I have observed in private hospitals, there is a big instructions put on the wall saying that what is the rights of the patients, what rights they have, what can they ask with the doctor and how they can be prepared and how everything happens. But I have never seen in a government hospital that patient is having all the rights to ask what type of treatment has been done and how the discharge will be done. What is there in the discharge summary? Sometimes there is no discharge summary at all at the government hospital. Then again, if the patient needs to be taken some other treatment higher, where the patient will go? And if he goes to some other hospital also, the doctor will ask him, earlier where did you see the treatment? Where is the procedure cards? Where is the report cards? And where is your investigation cards? And where is your discharge summary? What will this man give to that particular doctor when he asks so many n number of questions? So, whatever the treatment you are doing, do it in a proper procedure. And whatever the records that you are maintaining, not only for the government, please issue a record for the public also. And at the same time, it is a request for all the government sectors to see that you do your work properly. You do the work and satisfy yourself, because you all are saying, you are all are taking the government salary. Your government salary is not simply a Gandhi note or a Gandhi currency. It is a taxes, it is a revenues that is coming to the government in form of money by the citizens, by the public. So you do your 100% work, you put your 100% work and serve the country and serve the people who elect you as a leaders. Okay friends, if you think whatever I have spoke now is worth and meaningful, please like and give a comment. If you are watching it for the first time, please subscribe this channel. Thank you.